just doing your work properly on time with the given lectures. See, I think you can see that on board study I have drawn some lines. That means we are going to study about some important facts which are necessary for our life. As in last lecture, we have studied about exactly we can say the two most important diseases, Pushpur and Marasmus, which caused due to the deficiency of proteins. Okay, today we are going to deal with the vitamins. Why vitamins are important? What are different kinds of vitamins that you know? Vitamins used to start with vitamin A, B, C, D, and K. Okay, E is also there. Sorry, okay na? A, B, C, D, and K. So these are the important vitamins. So we are going to read about their functions, what disease caused due to the deficiency of particular vitamin, and what are the symptoms that due to which we can understand that we are suffering from this type of vitamins. Sorry, disease. Okay. So let's start. So our topics today for this is exactly the vitamins portion. Today we are going to study about vitamins. It's clear because you can also take out your book and study with me as I'm going through with you all. Okay. The number one disease is about, sorry, the number one vitamin is first vitamin A. Vitamin A. What does vitamin A do to us? Clear? This is vitamin A. We are going to study now vitamin A. Vitamin B, the main sources of vitamin A are green leafy vegetables, fruits, butters, egg yolks, carrots, and fish. Then, now what happens? What are the main function of vitamin A? They keep our eyes and hairs and skin healthy. Vitamin A keeps our eye, hair, and skin healthy. Okay? This is the first that we have studied. Now, if we are not taking proper vitamin A in our food, what should the deficiency disease, what type of deficiency disease occurs to us? That is night blindness. Night blindness. That means we won't be able to see clearly during night. Night means that during night we won't be able to see clearly. Okay? And what are the symptoms of that? How we can identify that we are suffering from night blindness? That is dryness of eyes and improper vision. Okay? Dryness of eyes and improper vision. Okay? Done. Now the next comes is vitamin B1. Just turn your pages. So vitamin B1. Now what vitamin B1? What are the sources of vitamin B1? Means what type of food if we are eating, we are getting vitamin B1. So egg, whole grains and sprouts. Sprouts, you know that the white portion which comes out if we shoved ground beans overnight and after that we tied up in a towel, sun, or usually maybe many of you have seen. So white just that I used to say now, that are the sprouts. Now what is the function of this? It's aid in digestion and maintains nervous system. Aids in digestion and maintains nervous system. Okay? Now, if we are not taking properly vitamin A in our diet, what should happen to us? What should happen now? That is beriberi. The word comes is berry. Well, it is a disease. We will suffer from this. So, what are the symptoms of this? Inflammation of nerves. Inflammation. Do you know by the word inflammation? Okay, I am telling you. Inflammation of nerves means that the nerves maybe swells up. Swells, you know. Now, with the swelling, we know, no? Swelling, we says, no? Swelling, sujan. That type of, we can say, the, inflammation of nerves means this. Digestive problems. Digestive problems. Then, heart abnormalities. Means the heart, we can say, it's not working properly. We have some problems we are facing while this. Okay. So this is a second B1. Number third comes vitamin B2. Vitamin B2. Now vitamin B2. What does the vitamin B2? We can get from the sources, they are egg, milk and green leafy vegetables. Okay. Then what is the function of keep skin and mouth healthy? Keep skin and mouth healthy. Okay. Now what is the disease caused by this? Skin disorders. Skin disorders. Okay. What are the symptoms of that? Irritation to eyes. Irritation of eyes. Irritation of eyes. Skin. And intestinal disorders. Intestinal disorders. Etc. So all you can see. So now we have completed three diseases over here. The next comes
help to resist
infectious. Infectious and keep healthy, keep teeth, gums and joints healthy. Okay, so this is a function of vitamin C. What is the disease caused by this? Is scurvy. S-C-U-R-V-Y. Scurvy. And what are the symptoms of that? Losing teeth, spongy blood, losing teeth, spongy and bloody gums, spongy and bloody, sorry, not bloody, it's bleeding. Bleeding gums, etc. and so on. Clear? So this is a symptoms for scurvy, that is if we lack of vitamin C. Next comes vitamin D. Vitamin D. Now vitamin D, what says? Vitamin D we can get from milk, fish, sunlight and eggs. Okay, so what is the abnormality? Actually it's eggs in the growth of normal growth of bones in children's. Okay, see children's. What is the disease caused by? This is rickets. It's rickets. And what happens? Weak bones, joint and bone deformities like bow legs and so on. Bow legs and so on. It is okay. Some more are there that you can go through your book. That is Pigeon chest, softening of ribs and protruding abdomen. The last is vitamin K. The last is vitamin K. What are the sources for vitamin K? That are spinach, cabbage and any other leafy vegetable that must be green. Okay, what are the function? Helps in blood clotting. lecture. But in today's lecture, according to this table, I will be just giving you some questions. So you have to solve and just